First Lady has always been our example of faithfulness and obedience to God's word and his ministry. The clothing donation is going October 27, 2021 at 9:30 a.m. Sister Jean and Sister Sean are asking for volunteers to meet at our church to help sort clothes for evangelism. We also need help putting backpacks together. Please contact them if you have any questions.
That's all right, Sister Glow. Amen.
Sunday school is here. We have Sunday school every Sunday. Please come out and join us at 8:15. And please invite friends and family. It is so much information given on Sunday.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Daily devotional. Our daily devotional calls is held Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday at 12 noon. And it's facilitated by Minister DeLon. Iron Man call is every Monday evening at 8 p.m. And the phone number is 1-857-216-6700. Access code is 334-336. And try to get on, man. Okay?
Amen.
Stop and pray. New time is Tuesday evening at 8:30 p.m. Phone number is the same number I just gave with the same action access code. Bible study is held on Wednesday on Wednesday morning at 11:30 a.m. and then in the evening at 7 p.m. to 8:30.
Yes.
But with the same phone number and access code.
Amen.
Do we have any first-time visitors? If so, please stand. Or someone that hasn't been here for a long time. So we're family today. Oh, no, we're back together. All of you, please stand and stand until you get a card so that you can fill it out. And we're glad to have you because you could have stopped anywhere on your way.
That's right.
Amen.
But you made it here.
Yeah.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Please, Gail, please fill out the card because we get them and I'm sure Pastor reads them. Okay, and all October birthdays will be given at the end of the month.
At this moment, I just want to take this time to honor First Lady.
Yeah.
However, as I explained last week, we're not honoring First Lady as much as we're honoring God.
Amen. Come on.
And this particular moment is a time that we're thanking God for all of the years that she gave here at St. Paul Family.
Amen. Yes. Thank you.
God is amazing.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
He's amazing, and he is a God of his word.
Hallelujah.
We had this plan to do quite some time ago, but we all just forgot about it. Amen.
That's right.
Let it go. But then someone came, and they donated money to the church.
Yeah.
And when I made that call, they can't be here today. They live up north. And they were coming down, but they have three kids, and it wasn't easy getting a babysitter. However, we're so glad that they even thought about us. And this came out of the blue. When they sent that to the church, it came out of the blue, and I was just elated. And then the Lord put it on my heart, this is the time to have a stage made.
Amen.
And I just want to thank Brother Lance.
Amen.
So many people to thank, and I got the names here because I knew I would forget somebody. Brother Lance, Sister Willa, she made the skirt.
Wow.
All the way around.
Nice.
I want to thank Deacon Craig and also Brother Kenny for lending their trucks to bring all of the lumber.
Yeah.
Amen. God is good. He always has a ram in the bush. Amen.
Sure enough. Amen.
Then I want to thank Deacon Herbert for his time. Funny story about this. Brother Lance and Deacon Herbert were gluing this carpet on, and I think they had more glue on them than the carpet. And they told me they were getting glue off for a few days after that. And then we had to glue a couple of more parts. So Deacon Herbert came and he was gluing these few more parts, and he had more glue on him then than he had on the first time. So I just give God praise for people like Deacon Herbert.
Amen.
And then Deacon John that helped.
Amen.
Praise God.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Sister Beanie for the flowers.
Amen.
And Sister Karen that helped put these flowers together.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
And then, not only that, but the flowers came from the Bryan family.
Amen.
Amen. A lot of them here. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Callum family. Everybody know Chet and Karen, the Callum family.
Yes.
Rogers. Mr. Rogers right over here also. And the Kenji family.
Amen.
Amen.
God praise for all of them.
Wow, beautiful.
Awesome. People were awesome with everything that they did. Deacon Davis was even here after cleaning up out there on the lots. We had a little situation where bottles were being thrown over here, and so we had to get the police, and they do their charts over here in the lot every weekend. So I give God praise
the Lord.
All of this is from the glory of God.
Amen.
Amen.
It's a beautiful situation.
Yes.
And I would ask that someone that can read out loud, please turn to Psalm 73. Psalm 73. It would be just like me to forget the scripture, so I'm looking it up myself. Psalms 73, and I think it's 23 and 24. Let's make sure. Bear with me just a moment. When you get old, you can't see, you can't remember stuff, and I'm telling you, getting old ain't for sissies. Read it out loud. Thank you, Deacon.
Psalm 73.
Yes.
Verse 24.
Yes.
You guide me with your counsel, and afterwards you will take me into glory.
And I think this is so befitting for this time.
Amen.
Because she portrayed just that thing.
Amen.
God counseled her. Just like the scripture said, he counseled her with all of the things that she went through, the blood, the sweat, the tears, all of the things she went through in building this, putting this together. And nonetheless, even from the start when we were at Cusera Middle School, prayers, I would come in sometimes, into our prayer room, which is in our front room, and she would be in that corner just praying. I know a lot of it was for me, and you all have been here, has heard this story. She kept a journal of everything. She would journal of everything that would happen, praying for folks and everything, and that's something that she really did. And she happened to, she had folders and folders, at least 20 of them, of just journaling and prayer and all of that. And she wouldn't throw them away, she would put them away. And so one day I found them. And of course I started reading them. And I could see Sunny in there. She would almost like scribble almost, but she knew what she was saying and God knew what she was saying.
Amen.
And I would see Sunny, and I'd see Daylon, I'd see Kimmy, I'd see Frank, I'd see Buck, I would see different names. I could make the names out. And it was a stack of them like that. And I must have went through about maybe five to seven of them. And I saw those names all the time. And then after we started the church, I picked them up and read some of them again. And I saw St. Paul Family Ministry, St. Paul Family Ministry, all through there. Just prayers, where she was praying, and where she was praying for people. Some of the names were in there. And you all know how confidential she was. She didn't tell anybody's business.
Amen.
She wasn't a gossiper or nothing like that. Nonetheless, she was praying. When we got in this place, we anointed all of these posts in this place. And I told that a lot of times. But however, I just want to make it known to everybody that's here today. She was one that would definitely pray.
Yes.
And in those prayers, she trusted who God was. She gave us all an example of what being in contact with God was all about.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So I'm just at this time, Brother Lance, can you come up, please? I just want to take this moment. Thanks. It says on this plaque, it says stage. It says, dedicated to St. Paul Family Ministries.
Amen.
In memory of First Lady Debbie Phillips,
Amen.
Mama Nani, by the German family. Some of you all remember Eileen, and then she got married later on. She got married a little later on, and she married Elijah German. And they got married, and now they have three kids. And a beautiful couple. And so I just give God praise for them blessing us. And we're going to take this time and dedicate this particular stage back to God for Him giving us Debbie Phillips.
Amen. Yes!
I just want to say, it's not easy being married at all. I want to tell everybody that's married that, but it is a blessing and a benefit if you serve the Lord.
Yes.
Because He charts your path. He tells you which way to go. He tells you how to be. She was on my case all the time. I can't say too much about me being on her case, but whew. She told me the time that I was asleep. I wasn't too much of a Christian at that time. I was a Christian, but I was, one of those Christians.
Come on, Pastor, take your time.
Anyway, she told me about the times that she used to get up at night and get her blessed oil. Put it all over my head. Sometimes she said she even rubbed me with the blessed oil.
Amen.
And if anybody knows about blessed oil and you trust it and believe in it, like the word says, it's going to be used for the blessing
of the Lord,
of His people.
Amen.
And she would pull it out in a second. And I remember one time we had did a marriage counseling in our house, and we came to the conclusion after that marriage counseling, because they were really going back and forth with each other. We said we'll never have any more marriage counseling in this house.
That's right.
And that came because marriage. That came because not long after that, we got into a heated debate. And the lady, first lady, went to the door, opened the door, and said, "Satan, you get out of here." And I said, "Well, that's the last marriage Councilman, we're gonna do, if we have to go to Panera Bread or wherever, that's where we'll go. We're not doing no more here.
Amen.
So I just give God praise because she was a person that stood up for holiness.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
My children could attest to that. They all can attest to that. They know that she was a woman that prayed. Sicknesses came. We went through all kind of sicknesses. Yes, I went to hospital after hospital. And this last time, I could not be with her. And that was very unfortunate because I never was without being with her when she had to go to the hospital.
Amen.
All of my children knew that whenever they were in the hospital, we were right there. Amen. Praying.
Yes.
Calling on the name of Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Trusting who Jesus was.
Yes.
Not only trusting who he was, but believing in who he was and not doubting who he was.
That's right.
And he's a healer. He said, by my stripes, we're healed.
Yes.
And so many times. And after, even after that situation and what we've been through, she got the perfect healing. So he's true to his word.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
So I just want everybody to stand on their feet for just one second. And let's just give God a hearty, hearty hand clap for him getting ready to come. Amen. About me being on a stage, and the ones that's been here a long time, they know I didn't even want these chairs when we were over there. We were sitting right there. That's where we sit. However, don't push the preacher up. Don't, wherever you go, don't push the preacher up. Go to your Bible and listen to what he says, but check it for yourself.
Amen. Amen.
You do that?
That's right, Pastor.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
St. Paul Family Ministries, don't look at me. I may mess up at any time, but don't look at me. I keep looking at Jesus, and as long as I'm looking at Jesus, y'all keep looking at Jesus.
Amen.
And even when I stop, keep on looking at him.
Yes.
And don't just look at him. Serve him and be obedient to him. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. That's what First Lady definitely would have wanted us to do.
Amen.
So we give God praise. At this time, we dedicate this stage in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Let me pray. Father in heaven, you are mighty God.
Yeah.
And we want to start by saying thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you,
Lord. Yes.
If we had 1,000 tongues, we couldn't thank you enough.
Yes, Lord.
So Lord, we stop and we pause and we say, Lord, you have truly, truly blessed us.
Yes.
For this thought of 17 years that you've given us with St. Paul Family Ministries. And so, Lord, I thank you because we're not just doing it, we're being steadfast doing it. And so, Lord, I ask that you bless the people of St. Paul, the friends of St. Paul, the family of St. Paul Family Ministries. Lord, bless it. Bless this stage for the use that it should be used for. And I'm asking that you bless it after I'm gone, after Daylon is gone, after whomever is gone, let this church still be here. Lord, you're a
yes.
great God. If you don't come back before this, before we're gone, Lord, we're going to go back with you. And if you let us bring the stage, we're going to give it to you.
Yes.
So we give you praise and honor and glory. And we thank you in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
There's there's tears here, but they're not tears of fear, not tears of non-hope. And we want you to know that God loves each and every one of you.
Thank
you. And I thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for being able to come out and just take this time with us together. Amen. 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 I thought I was going to have to call the two deacons to get Brother Lance back up.
So we're going to pray. And so I'm going to ask everybody to stand. We're still following social distancing guidelines. This is usually the time when we come up to the altar for our corporate prayer, but I just want you to stand right where you are.
Amen.
First floor.
Yes. It is different standing up here. Kind of makes you real. But God is good.
Yeah.
And I know they're tears. But when you think of an earthly angel, you can't help but think about my mom.
Amen.
And I'm just one that I feel honored, I feel blessed that I came from a woman that was just so loving.
Yep.
Yes.
And she touched everyone she came in contact with.
Yep.
There's no way you can even be anywhere close, in a close vicinity of my mom and not be touched.
Amen.
She had a way with her smile.
Yep.
With her eyes, with her hands.
Amen.
I think that's what I miss the most.
Hallelujah.
To sit by that lady in some kind of way, she was gonna be rubbing you, touching you. And I'm just so thankful that I was able to share her with you guys.
Yeah.
You know, it's a lot you can say about different people, but when you can truly say that you saw a woman of God, when you truly saw a woman that loved, a woman that cared for others, I'm honored to be her son.
Thank you.
In fact, she called me her only begotten. Until, of course, Mika got married and Elton came and had to share. Pray for me. And then John came. But by then I knew how to share. But she loved this church. And she loved all the members of this church. She was a praying woman. You guys know, those of you in the hospital, she would come.
That's right.
Yeah.
Those of you that lost loved ones, she would come.
Yeah.
Those of you who had different things at your schools, she would come.
Yeah.
There's nothing that that lady wouldn't do for you. And it just makes me proud. It just makes me proud.
Yep, yep, yep.
Just makes me proud.
Yes.
Yes. All right, amen. Glory.
Let's pray. Most gracious and heavenly Father, Lord, you are the author and the finisher of our faith. Lord, you are the creator of everything. Lord, you're the first, you're the last. You're the great I am. In fact, we can just say you are and just put a dash there. Because there's nothing that you are not. Lord, we thank you for what today represents here at this church. Lord, we thank you for the servant that you sent to us. For all the years she was here, we thank you for her life. Lord, we thank you for her legacy. We thank you for her love.
Yep.
We're thankful that she has such a love for you first, a love for this church, and a love for others. Us as a family, we shed tears of joy, not because she wasn't a good woman, but because she was a woman of Christ. And so, Lord, as her spirit lives on in this place, let her love flow as it flowed when she touched and prayed on every post. Putting the blessed oil all on the walls of this place. Her and my dad. Lord, I'm just so thankful to see the growth from an idea in our living room to all the way here.
Amen.
Now, Lord, your people, we cannot forget your people. They have their different petitions, Lord, and we're laying those petitions at your feet.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Lord, you know what the needs are because you know us because you created us. And you know every hair on our heads. And so, Lord, whatever your people are going through, whether it be financial, whether it be marital, whether it be parents, children, job situation, whatever it is, whatever it may be, Lord, we're asking you to meet that need. We're asking you to fix it, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We're asking you to touch, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We're asking you to heal, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We're asking you to bind us together as a people, as a church. Because the church is not a building. The church is us. And so, Lord, we just want your Holy Spirit to rain down all through this place. When people walk in this door, we want them to feel your presence. Because we're not a church about death. We are a church that preaches life. And in you, we will have life. Not only that, we can have life more abundantly. And not only that, but we can have life everlasting.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
And so, Lord, we thank you for what you did on the cross for us many, many, many years ago.
Thank you.
We don't take it lightly that you shed your blood on the cross on Calvary.
Your blood, Lord.
And we're so glad that it didn't end there, but on that third day, you got up with all power in your hands. And so because of that, we know that whatever it is we bring and lay at your feet, it will be done if it's your will. And so, Lord, I'm asking you to hear and accept this prayer. Lord, I want to end this prayer with simply saying, Lord, your will. Nothing more, nothing less, and nothing else. In Jesus' name we ask. Thank God. Amen.
Amen. Thank the Lord.
God is good, isn't he? All the time. All the time God is good.
Yes, he is. Praise the Lord.
Praise God for his grace, first of all, his mercy. And I'm just elated, first of all, that you're here to celebrate with us. And not only that you're here to celebrate with us, but that you'll go home knowing something that you didn't know before.
Amen.
So God has given us a message to give you. And I have to do as I've been called to do. And that's to give you God's word. Somebody out there right now is saying, oh, what this guy gonna say? His brother gonna say. God has given us a word. Let's turn in your Bibles to Revelation. 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 22nd chapter. That's the last chapter in the Bible. Last chapter in the Bible. Just want you, your minds to just listen to what God has to give you in this particular word. Pull out your yellow sheet of paper, and I only have two sets of fill-ins on there. So when I get to that part, I'll let you know what it is. You also can look at the screen, and the screen will show you exactly what to write. And so we thank God for his mercy. If you're thanking the Lord for his mercy, just say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, 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 yes. God is a God of grace. As Minister DeLon said, he's a triune God. Yes. Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. However, I want you to know, I want you to make sure that you know, I want to make sure that you know he's one God.
Yeah.
We don't believe in a God that's polytheistic. That means more than one God. Some religions, I don't call us a religion, I call us a relationship with God. However, we're not a polytheistic God because we want serve one God in three personalities. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Do you have that? Stand on your feet if you have it while we read God's word.
Okay, here.
All right. And this is how it reads. We're going to the third verse, and we're going to read 3 through 5. Revelation 22, 3 through 5. And this is what it says. And there shall be no more curse. Let's say that together. And there shall be no more curse. Got that?
Amen.
All right. But the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it. Everybody hearing this, right?
Yes.
Reading it. There shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and the Lamb, which is Jesus, shall be in it. Got that?
Yes.
Everybody got it?
Amen.
All right. Because this particular message is a message where a lot of people, I'll just say people, they get all confused because they don't understand what God does, what God did, and what he's doing. And so we go on to verse 4. I'm sorry. Lamb shall be in it, and his servant shall serve him. That's the last part of verse 3.
Amen.
Then verse 4. And they shall see his face, and his name shall be in their forehead.
Yeah. Amen.
Some of your Bibles say on their forehead. Yeah. I'll explain that in a moment. 5 says, and there shall be no more night there, and they need no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign forever and ever. Unique verse, isn't it?
Amen.
So the title of this message is When Your World Looks Dark. When your world looks dark. You may be seated. Amen. Praise God for the house of the Lord. And he wants to talk to us today. So look at that yellow paper and look at what you're focusing on. We say when your world looks dark, amen? But I want you to look at what you're focusing on. And I want you to know that there is a launching of God's mercy. There's a launching of God's mercy. So I want you to look at listen and see if you can feel and hear and see the launching of God's mercy in this particular message. Amen?
Amen.
So we find out that there's no more curse.
Uh-huh.
We read that. And then we find out, I'm only giving you 2 points today, and we find out that there is no more darkness.
All right, come on.
Now, there's been times in your lives, amen,
amen,
where you have been in a messed up situation. Can I be myself?
Amen, yes.
You all gonna pray for me?
Yes.
In a messed up situation, you have been through trials and tribulations, you have been through tests, and you have been through chastisement. You've been through all type of things in your life. Even we get to points to where our loved ones are hurt, or they're in a bad situation, and we're hurting because they're hurting. And so those are times of spiritual darkness. I taught the little kids class today for Sunday school, and they were from 5 to 7 years old, and boy, you'd be surprised what they know. And I was back there learning from them when they should have been learning from me, but the message that I was telling them I was talking about the first five books of the Bible, and the first five books of the Bible is called the Pentateuch. And the Pentateuch tells us is a foundation, it's a base of how much God loves all of us, every person in a seat in this building. God loves you with all of his heart, soul, mind, and strength. He made you in his own image. That's right. How much he loves you.
Amen, yes,
so
yes.
So it becomes powerful when you think about the launching of God's mercy on us every day. The Bible teaches us that in Lamentations 3:23, it says, every morning we have brand new mercies. You
yes.
all have heard
yes.
that goes here regularly. You've heard that. Brand new mercies every morning. God does not, he doesn't forget.
Come on.
He gives you a box of brand new mercies
yes.
every morning.
Yes, yes.
And I look at that and I say, wow. When I realize that I'm waking up with mercy at the bottom of my bed.
Come on.
I'm waking up with mercies, and God knows when to put them in place for us. Amen?
Amen.
And so I find out that it's a beautiful thing how God never forgets about us.
Come on.
We might forget about him.
Say it, Pastor.
But every morning, that mercy is right there waiting.
Yes. Show
to
now.
Bless you, to watch over you, to keep you, to keep
Thank
you from
you.
Danger, to keep you from harm, to keep you from hurt. But the sad portion of that is a lot of times we forget who he is.
Come on, say it.
And we forget to thank him for the mercy.
Yes, come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus, for the mercies
yes,
every morning.
Yes, Father, thank you.
I went and picked up a family this morning, and I went across the freeway.
Yep.
And I got the van washed this morning, and I was up early, and I was just thanking God for another day.
Yes.
And after I got the van washed, I just cruised to the freeway, and I waited for the light turned on the freeway. Getting on the freeway, and I'm trying to look through the mirrors, and I couldn't see nothing. And I'm trying to get on the freeway, merge onto the freeway, but I couldn't see nothing. So I had to turn around and look back to see if it was anybody there. And then I realized my mirrors were pushed in. And so I pulled over to the side. And I said, I can't get out on this freeway. And I just prayed. Got out on the freeway. Went on one side, pushed the mirror out, on the other side, pushed the mirror out, and got back on the freeway and got on my way. Do you know that was a mercy?
Yes, come on, Pastor.
That was a mercy.
Yes, praise the Lord.
Anything could have happened.
Yes.
But God watched over me.
Come on now.
The mercy was I got there, got the family, and got back here.
Yes.
That was a mercy.
Praise the Lord. Thank you.
And I thanked him all the way.
Yes.
Thanked him for the mercy that he gave.
Come on.
But there was a time in my life where I realized, Sister Darlene had taught a class just a few weeks ago in the book of Jonah. We went through Jonah. We had a lot of people on the calls, and we went through the book of Jonah, and we found out in Jonah 2:8, this is what it says. Those who regard worthless idols forsake their mercy.
Uh-oh.
Y'all hear me?
Come on, Pastor, say it.
That's not on the screen yet. But it says, those who worship worthless idols
come on.
Forsake their mercy.
Come on.
Now here's the kicker, the killer is this. When we worship those idols,
come on.
We make whatever that idol is worthless to God.
That's right, come on.
So God forbid someone has their husband or their children as an idol.
Say it.
God says, I will have no other God before me.
That's right.
I'll have no other idol before me.
Come on.
I'll have nothing before me. I won't have any other jobs before me.
That's right.
I won't have people before me. I won't have my motorhome or my SUV or whatever.
Yeah. Come on.
My jewelry or whatever.
That's it.
I won't have it before my clothes.
That's right.
My friends.
Come on.
Because what we do when we do that, we make them worthless.
That's right.
That's what Jonah said.
Come on.
And so we take advantage of Lamentations, which says we have new mercies every day.
Yep.
And when we don't thank God for that, and we put something in the place of God.
Come on.
Do I need to go on?
That's
it. Am I making it plain?
Yes, yes, yes.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
Amen. So God is saying, he says, you keep the curse there when you do that.
Yep.
And you're living in darkness.
Come on.
And sometimes it seems like our world is dark.
Come on.
Seems like we can't just get through. It's always something in the way.
Darkness.
Always something ugly. I told the kids this morning, I said, when you can't answer a question that I've given you already, then that's a darkness.
Come on.
And they said, how? I don't understand. So I explained it to them. I said, you have to build your foundation. There's a foundation. There's a base. They knew what a base was, and they knew, and afterwards they knew what the foundation was, and we built some Bibles. Well, we built some things on top of it, some other boxes. And I said, if your foundation is not built on the Bible,
yep.
on God's word,
come on,
then things can happen. And what happens, you get afraid when it happens. You get messed up inside
yep.
when it happens. So he's saying to us, trust me
yep.
when you can't trace me. He's saying to us, have faith in me
yep.
when you can't find me.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So hold on to who Jesus truly is. Uh-huh. And so I look at this portion of scripture and I say, no more curse. Galatians 3:13, this is what it says. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law.
Yes.
Now, I'm talking about the law of Moses.
Yeah.
When God gave Moses the law.
Yeah.
And what happened when he gave Moses the law, God gave it to him to give to the people, like I'm giving to you right now.
That's right. Come on.
But I have to go all the way back to Genesis. In Genesis, it said that man and woman sinned in the Garden of Eden.
Uh-huh.
A lot of y'all have heard about that, right?
Yep, yep.
And so when they sinned, God got angry.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Amen?
Amen.
And it's something funny about that portion of scripture. God, when he was in there, he said to Adam, what are you doing? He says, why are you hiding? He says, I'm hiding because I'm naked. And before he can get anything out, God said, who told you you were naked? He didn't even give him a chance to answer. He said, did you eat from the forbidden fruit? And he backed up. He was scared. He didn't know. And so he got shook up. First thing he said, she gave it to me. Then after that, he got on her, and she said, the snake gave it to me.
Uh-huh.
He wasn't a snake then. He was the most beautiful animal in the kingdom.
Yeah.
Yes.
He said, he gave it to me. And he got angry. And you all know what he did?
Yeah.
He cursed the ground that they lived on.
Yeah.
He cast them out of the garden.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he cursed man,
yeah.
saying man will have to work by the sweat of his brow.
Yeah.
He
right.
cursed the woman,
yeah.
and the woman has to bear children
yep.
in pain.
Yeah.
Y'all love epidurals that had babies? Wow. Remember when they didn't have, some of y'all remember when they didn't have epidurals, right?
That's right.
Are we progressing? You know, that's just, hey, listen to me close.
Come on.
That's just a little bit of the curse being taken away.
Yeah.
Come on, that's right.
Y'all hear me?
Yes. Yeah.
And so you think about what's happening, and when we're living in this curse that we're living in, it was given by God. A lot of people think it was given by the devil. No, it wasn't. God cursed the earth.
Yeah.
Come on.
And that's the whole story, is that he is refurbishing the earth. And the way he's going to do that, he says, when you pray that regular prayer that's in the Bible, the model prayer, thy kingdom come.
Yeah.
That's right.
That means his kingdom is going to come.
Uh-huh.
It's going to burn this place up, and everybody that is not like Christ will be raised to see the Lord in the air. I'm getting into another part of this, of the Not the message, yeah, well, the message.
That's all right, Pastor.
Let me go back to what I'm talking about. But if you understand what I mean, if you can just think about your life.
Come on.
We are not getting any younger. Things are getting harder.
Yep.
When these men was down here doing the stage and we were getting the wood, this is really good. This goes with this very well.
Oh boy.
I couldn't put the wood up on the truck for one thing. I could barely take it off. Then bring it back. And when I was coming out of the door, I was breathing like I ran a 400. Things are different.
Come on, Pastor said.
They're not the way they used to be.
Yep, yep.
And everybody in the building is getting older.
Yep.
So when you get to my age, right, if you're not taking care of yourself, or let me put it another way, if you're still in the curse.
Come on. Uh-huh.
If you're still in the darkness.
Yep, yep.
How are you going to navigate through the light?
Come on.
My.
Light and darkness doesn't mix. What happens when you turn on a light in a dark room? At least you have something to follow.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
That's why this message says, when your world looks dark, and I don't know if you've been there where the hurt is, or where the detriment is, or where the mess is, or where the badness is, or where the distrust is, when it's dark, when somebody has let you down, or somebody has said something to hurt your feelings, when that's dark, when you go into that darkness that is keeping you from moving forward.
Come on, say
and
it.
And we start focusing on the negative,
yeah, you do,
instead of focusing on the positive.
Come on.
Let me say it another way. When we start focusing on Satan and his works instead of God and his blessings.
Yep, yep. Huh. Come on.
Then we mess up because there's no light there.
That's right.
And so I don't know about you, but I think about the mercies that I got that morning.
Come on.
Oh, I'm liking this up here.
Amen.
I may not come down there all the time because I'm going to have to go all the way around that side and that side. But it's okay. You know me, I'll jump.
Praise the Lord.
God. They over there saying, no, please don't. Whatever you do, don't jump. Praise God.
Yeah.
But God is just that type of God.
Yes, yes.
And so we look at what Galatians said. He has redeemed us from the curse of the law.
Yep,
in other words, when I became saved,
yep,
and
yep,
you became saved, when you became a Christian, yep, or a believer, then he actually took the curse away from you.
Sure enough. Uh-huh.
Making sense now?
Yeah. Yep, yep, yep.
He's taken it away from you, and he has endowed you with light.
Yes, yeah, come on.
So every step that I take, I'm taking that step in Jesus Christ. Does that mean I got to walk around with a Bible all the time?
Nope.
No, but I sure got it on my phone.
Come on.
Amen. Yeah. If I got to pull out the word, I'll pull it out.
Yeah. Yes, yes, yes.
They may be looking for a Bible, but I say, listen to this real close. Siri, give me Matthew 28, 19 and 20. Listen to this real close. Matthew 28, 19 and 20. There it is. I can go to reading if I want to.
That's right. Come on, Pastor.
Or I can just say, read this. So are we getting better?
Yes.
God has brought me out of the darkness.
Come on.
And brought us all into the light.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you.
Better.
Uh-huh.
Yes, yes.
Yes,
God,
we are.
God says you don't have to be caught up because I redeemed you. Don't be caught up in that curse that I gave to the world when I put them on notice that they've got to toil for a living.
Come on.
You got to make the ground give you food.
Come on.
You've got to birth children in pain.
Come on.
You've got to go through all of that negativity because of all this that happened. But it doesn't have to be that way.
Uh-huh.
Oh, have mercy.
Come on.
So to redeem it means to buy back. Are y'all with me?
Come on, take your time.
Are to deliver a paying price. This is what we're doing when he redeemed us. This is what's happening. It says the curse of the law is death. The penalty of breaking it, its commandments, we must know Christ delivers. And he delivers those under the law from paying the penalty of death. And he demands it by the law. The law demands that you pay.
Come on.
If you don't accept Jesus. But when you, listen close, when you accept Jesus, guess who steps in?
The Lord.
And guess who, what he steps in with? He steps in with the payment.
Come on.
Paying for your sins.
Yes.
My sins. Every sin that ever was. Every sin that ever will be. Ah, this is when your life is in darkness.
Come on.
When your world is in darkness. When the ugliness is in darkness. Reach into your bag of mercies and grab that bag of mercies and say, Lord, you presented me this morning. This is a prayer that you can pray. Lord, I need to get out of this situation. Show me how to get out of this situation.
Come on.
One of the major things with all of us is bills.
Come
I
on,
ain't
say.
Got an amen off of that.
Come on, Pastor,
rich.
Amen.
Everybody in here, rich men. Lord, I know you got to be humble enough to say, Lord, I know I messed this up.
That's right. Come on, Pastor.
Lord, help
say
me
it.
Out of this.
Yep,
will you?
Yep.
Again.
Come
amen.
On, Pastor.
Praise
amen.
God. So yep. I look at God's word and how gracious and how merciful, how powerful and loving he is, how he takes time,
yep.
he stands back, and he waits for you to move the idol.
Come on, say it.
Amen. Y'all with me?
Yep, take your time.
Move the idol out of the way.
Uh-huh.
Put me in that place. And guess what? The light comes on.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
He shows me how to navigate through that.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to eat crow and go back.
Come on.
Eat crow, huh? Sometimes you got to go back.
Come on, Pastor.
And you have to fix things.
Yeah.
Don't be so full of pride.
That's it right there.
That you can't go back.
Say it.
Sometimes you have to apologize. Don't be so full of pride.
That's it right there.
That you can't apologize.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
Sometimes you have to just fall on your knees.
There it is.
How many has fell on their knees?
Yeah.
And asked God for forgiveness?
Come on, Pastor.
Are you too prideful to ask God for forgive me for whatever I did?
That's it right there.
I know I messed this up. But Lord, some kind of way, hover your angels around me. Some kind of way, pour the mercy over my head. Lord, fix the situation.
Yes, Lord.
From the bottom of your heart with obedience to God.
That's it.
Who is the one who fixes everything.
Uh-huh.
And so I look at your paper, your yellow paper here. Christians today need the truth of Galatians 3:13. Christians today need the truth of Galatians 3:13. And so what do you mean, Pastor Sonny, by why do we need the truth of Galatians 3:13? Well, listen close. The blessing of Abraham, y'all ever heard that statement? It's really salvation by grace through faith. The blessing of Abraham is salvation through our faith. It's grace that brings our faith. Grace through faith. It's salvation. God saves us. He makes us a believer. And the way we become a believer is by our faith and the grace that he has just given us. And once he's given us that grace and I have the faith, then he makes me a believer.
That's
he
right.
makes me saved.
Yes.
He makes me filled with his Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And so at the time that happens, every day I must ask God to fill me completely with the Holy Spirit. When he does that, he opens up the light. Ah, that's what he does for you. He fixes the situation where we can understand and and ask God because of obedience for whatever we need. And he's, the Bible says, he's faithful and just to answer your prayer.
Come on.
Yes.
But you got to be true. And who knows whether you're true or not? God does.
God does.
God does. Amen?
Amen.
Are you still with me? Because the penalty of death required by God must first be paid. Yes, I just told you that. So the Lord Jesus was made a curse in order that God might reach out to both Jews and Gentiles in grace. Y'all hearing me? I didn't get an amen.
Amen.
Do I need to read it again? Oh, boy, have mercy. Y'all gonna make me stay longer? No, please don't. So the Lord Jesus made a curse. The Lord Jesus was made a curse in order that we all could be saved, that God might reach out to both you, which is the Gentiles, and also the Jews, which is God's chosen people.
Yeah.
And then he'll save us. He'll fill us with his spirit. He'll make us believers. He'll make us saints of God. He'll make us saved and sanctified. A lot of you all have heard that. And that's all because of Abraham. And Jesus, listen close, was a descendant of Abraham. All through the scriptures, when you read the Bible, all through the scriptures, that it says that the blessing of Abraham, the blessing of for the nations will come through Abraham. Uh-huh. And guess who Jesus' descendant is? Abraham. Everybody say Abraham.
Abraham.
Thank God for Abraham, because through that line, 42 generations, came Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And when Jesus Christ went to the cross, he went there for a reason, and the reason was to save you and me and keep us from the darkness that's in the world.
Amen.
When your world looks dark, look for Jesus.
That's right, amen.
Just call on his name, and things start to brighten up.
Yes.
When you look for Jesus, you'll find him. He'll be there for you.
Yeah.
But you've got to be true from the depths of your soul that he's a true and living God.
Yeah.
And when you believe that he's a true and living God and you call on him and ask him for the forgiveness of your past, then what he does, he showers light down on your soul.
Yes, praise the Lord.
And then you can walk in the newness of life.
Yeah.
You can walk in the brightness of life.
Yeah.
You can walk in the light.
Yeah.
Oh, remember that song? Walk in the light.
Yeah.
Beautiful light. Somewhere the dew drops from mercy shine bright. Oh, have mercy.
Yeah.
Woo. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
I got a choir over there. Praise God. That's what he does.
Yeah.
That's what he does.
Praise the Lord.
So I look at Proverbs 3:33. Listen to what it says about the curse. The curse of the Lord is on the house.
Uh-huh.
Is that up on the screen?
Yes. Yes.
Is it a little line through the house?
No.
Okay, I didn't put it there. I put it on my paper. But it's a little line through house.
Yes.
But listen to the rest of it. It says, the curse of the Lord is on the house of the wicked.
Yeah.
That's why I put a line through it. And it says, but he blesses the home of the just.
Yeah.
There's a difference between house and home.
Yeah.
Oh, when you're sanctified, when you're a believer, I mean a true bona fide believer.
Come on.
Your house becomes a home.
Amen.
Yes.
When you're in a den of wickedness.
Come on.
Get me right now. When you're in a den of wickedness.
Yep, yep.
You're in a house.
Yeah.
Let me testify about my house. My house is a den of not wickedness, but it's the den for Jesus.
That's right.
And so my house is not a house anymore. It's a home.
Yeah.
It becomes a place of sanctity. It becomes a place of beauty.
Yes.
It becomes a place of peace.
Yes.
It becomes a place of kindness.
Yes.
Though sometimes folks folks get on my nerves.
That's right.
But I'll get on my knees.
Yes.
When they get on my nerves, I get on my knees.
I like that. I like that.
And I'll stay there until I get an answer from the Lord.
Uh-oh.
And don't get me wrong, most of the times it's because I got the problem.
Come on, take it
down. Do you know that's one of the biggest and beautiful things you can do about the light?
Come on.
Is when you forgive somebody.
Yep.
You take it off of you.
Yeah.
When you give it to Jesus.
Yep.
You take it off of you, and you don't have to worry about it no more.
That's it right there.
You don't have to stress.
Yep.
You don't have to worry about how I'm going to get back.
Uh-huh.
Because Father has already taken care of the problem.
That's it right there, Pastor.
The Lord said, vengeance is mine.
Yeah.
In other words, when you get a chance, read Psalms 36. Uh-huh. You'll get down there where you'll find that you will see that my hand has been in the mix. You'll see that I've straightened out the situation.
Yes, you will.
You'll see that the hurt has been fixed. Mm-hmm. Not that you're supposed to get happy and revel in it. No.
Come on.
He says, know that I am God.
Yeah.
And that I'm true to my word.
Yep. Yeah.
And
that's
so
right,
I found out when I do that, the hurt is taken away.
It's lifted. Come on.
I wonder how this last hurt was taken away.
Come on.
Oh, I went to God. I used to say praying when I went walking every day, I would walk. And I said, Lord, thank you for my life and thank you for my wife.
That's right. Come on.
Every day I did it. And every day that I did it, little by little, more and more,
come on,
the hurt went away.
That's it. That's it. Praise the Lord. That's it.
Doesn't mean that the Lord's not going to let you know that that person was real, that person was there, that person was love.
Yeah.
Sometimes I ponder on it, but I have to go to.
Yep.
Because what I feel that's happening when that time comes is the darkness is coming over.
Yes.
Y'all with me?
Uh-huh. Yep.
So when your world looks like it's in the dark, Proverbs says, it says, make sure your home is a home, because I bless the ones that have a home.
Yep.
And so you've heard about the curse, and I hope you understand, because when your world looks dark, remember that launching of God's mercy, because there is no more curse. Jesus was made the curse. That's the point for that point. Amen?
Amen.
And so there is no more darkness. Listen, Thessalonians 5:5, this is what it says about no more darkness. You are sons of light and sons of the day. Oh, this is beautiful. You're sons of light and you're sons of the day. We are not of the light, nor are we of the darkness. That's Thessalonians 5:5. And in this particular scripture, Paul is speaking spiritually. And when he's speaking spiritually, he's telling you, yes, I'm not in darkness anymore. I'm a person of light because he has saved me.
Yes.
And there's a glory, y'all. Everybody say glory.
Glory.
There's a glory that comes over you.
Yes, it is.
That glory that comes over you is light. Yes. In other words, you don't get bent out of shape when somebody approaches you.
Nope.
When they're all raw or something is going haywire or they don't like something, you don't have to get bent out of shape because that shield of glory.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That brightness
of
light
comes
over you.
Yes, it does.
People don't realize what's happening. They just, sometimes they need to get angrier. But those angels are behind that light.
Yes.
And then their light shines over. Then Jesus is up looking, and then his light shines over. Yes. And then God is over him, the three. And then his light.
Ooh. Come on.
You want to know what that means?
Come on.
What does it mean, Pastor?
It means that the brightness in you is so light.
Yes.
That his name is on your head.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
That's why the Bible said in your head,
it
shines from the inside out.
That's it.
How do I get that light right there?
Come on.
Jesus said, I died on Calvary for a reason.
Yeah.
Ephesians tells me, for though once your heart was full of darkness, the Lord, and you should show it. Amen. Yes, that shows it. When people come at you sideways,
come on.
Oh, the light shows it. The brightness and the beauty of the Holy Spirit. Listen, on the natural side, yes, I may get bent out of shape. I may get ugly. I may start cussing back or fussing back. I may do anything.
Yep.
But when I have the light,
come on.
When I'm full of the glory,
that's it.
On the spiritual side,
yep.
Oh, the Lord says, people don't like this verse, but the Lord says, if they slap you, give them the other cheek to slap. And so I realize, doesn't mean that they're going to happen all the time, because usually the angels step in.
Yes, yes.
Oh, have mercy. I remember the story where this particular man was talking against God, talking against him, talking about him, and he was just going, and a gnat flew in his mouth and choked him to death. I remember where the Titanic went out in the ocean. The man said, the builder said, not even God can sink this ship. What happened?
Come on.
God, what did I tell you about God in the beginning?
Yes.
He made an iceberg.
Yes.
That was so solid.
Come on.
Sink that ship.
Yep.
Don't take God lightly.
Yes.
Take him how big he truly is.
That's right.
You serve, if you're a Christian, if you're in this building, if you're a believer, if you're in this building right now, God said, I am grace, I am mercy, I am your shield, I am your guide, I am the light,
yes.
I am the glory.
Yes.
I went to Calvary,
yes,
for the glory.
Yes.
On the spiritual side, I went to Calvary,
yes,
for the light. I went to Calvary,
yes,
because I love you and you and you. And
yes,
there's a reason.
Come on, take your time.
And that reason is, my father said, He said, listen, I want you to go down there.
Mm-hmm.
And when you go down there, I want you to take that curse away that I put on the earth.
Yes.
Yep, yep,
he
yep.
said, I want you to take that darkness away that you put on the earth.
Yes,
when God was on Calvary, the rocks started reeling and the ground started shaking.
Yes.
When he went to Calvary and everything started happening, the stars refused to shine.
Yes.
The moon went away in blood. The son said, I just quit.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
When he went to Calvary, all those things happened. Those were natural things. But in the spiritual is when he rose from the dead.
Come on.
In the spiritual, he gave you life and you life and you life, me life, him life. He gave us all life. He gave us the light of the world.
Yeah.
He gave us the light for the world.
Yes.
He gave us the light. He gave us the glory.
Yes.
He gave us the love. He gave us the peace,
yes,
the understanding,
hallelujah,
the joy,
thank
the pureness.
Yes.
He gave us all of those things.
Yes.
And so now that Jesus gave us the light, I thank him for his love.
Yes.
I thank him for his joy.
Yes.
I thank him for his peace.
Yes.
I thank him for his long,
yes,
suffering, which is patience for me.
Yes.
I thank him for his gentleness.
Yes.
I thank him for his goodness.
Yes.
I thank him for his grace.
Hallelujah.
Thank him for his faith. Thank him for his meekness. Thank him for temperance. Thank him for his understanding.
Yes.
Because,
yes,
they're all for you,
yes,
and they're all for me.
Praise,
yes,
the Lord.
God,
hallelujah,
bless you. God keep you.
Hallelujah.
God make his face to shine.
Hallelujah.
He's just that perfect God.
Yes.
Everybody stand on your feet.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
God is an awesome God.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
He's a gracious and wonderful God.
Praise
and
the Lord.
And then he is a patient God.
Yes.
I thank God for who we serve.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
You may not be the best person in the world.
Come on.
God don't care.
That's it.
He went to Calvary just for you.
That's right.
Yes.
And so when he went to Calvary, what I like about that story is this. He didn't stay there.
That's it.
Yes.
Take your time.
He didn't stay there.
Yes.
Thank God he did.
He got up.
Yes.
I think everybody in the building needs to say that. He got up.
He got up.
And when he got up with all power
in his hand.
In his hand.
Yes, yes, Pastor.
And that means his power to save whomever You may be.
Yes, praise the Lord.
So there may be someone in the building that doesn't know Christ as their personal, I put emphasis on that personal, personal Savior. And if you don't, now is the time to come. And you don't have to come. Oh, I wish you would, because God says, if you're ashamed of me before men, I'll be ashamed of you before my Father.
That's right.
But maybe you want to do it in private. We have people right over there. If you are a man, you can go with one of our deacons. But if you are just one of those persons that are feeling in your heart, or the pull, you're feeling the pull, or the conviction of who Jesus Christ truly is.
Yeah.
Some of you in the building don't know that Jesus is God.
Yeah. That's right.
God is Jesus.
Yes.
And they both are the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
They're all one.
That's it.
Same person. Same person.
Yes.
Boy, God has a plan, doesn't he?
Yes,
he knows how to get us out of stuff, because he can dispatch whatever he wants to dispatch.
That's right.
Depends on your situation. Sometimes he sends angels. But I just thank God, because he thinks the sin is whatever.
Yes.
Everything about him is good.
Yes.
So think about your life. Is your life good?
Yes.
Is your life all positive?
Yes.
If it is, thank God.
Thank God.
Because even our lives is like filthy rags to God.
That's right.
So I had to take my filthy rags and give them to the Lord.
That's right.
You.
Come on.
Oh, I had washed some clothes, and I left a sock out. And I saw the sock under my shoe rack. And I pulled it out. And I was missing one sock when I was folding up. But I looked at the sock and said, man, this is dirty. I forgot that. So I threw it in the washing machine for the next wash. Some of us need to be thrown in the washing machine.
That's right. Come on.
I know I had to be thrown. I think he had to wash me about four times.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank God that he did.
Yeah.
So maybe somebody in the building right now doesn't know Jesus. And I'm here to, all of this is great. She would say the same thing. All of this is great.
Yeah.
Brother Obi, where is he back there? He reminded me something this morning. He said, we're going to have a beautiful service today, but she's too busy up there dancing right now. She's still in her first day.
Praise the Lord.
I said, man, you're right. You're right. She's still in her first day. Still worshiping, because the Bible says in two different places, one day with the Lord is like a thousand years.
Yes.
Isn't that something?
Yes.
God got it covered.
Yes.
God got it covered. Yes. Got it covered.
Yes. Covered.
Thank
you. Praise the Lord. Saved, it's a light on your shoulder. Yes. Come on.
And it will tell you, okay, that's not cool.
That's right.
It talks your language.
Yeah.
exact same thing. Father, you're a great God. Lord, we love you with all of our heart. Lord, we've done it as you commanded, yet there is room. So Lord, I ask that the seeds that have been planted today, that someone would come along and water those seeds. That you would bless everybody in the building in a special way. Lord, I ask that you would give them the desires of their heart. But before you do, Lord, bring it to their attention where they're coming from. Where those blessings have been coming from. We love you, and we ask that you hear our prayer in Jesus' name. Maybe there's someone who does not have a church home, and you're looking for a place of worship. St. Paul Family Ministries is a church that loves the Lord, and we teach the unadulterated gospel.
Yes.
We teach about Jesus Christ. We show you. We take you by the hand, and we teach you what is right. So if you're that person and you want to join with St. Paul Family Ministries, you're always welcome. But if you want to join with St. Paul Family Ministries, you can come right now and we'll send you with one of our directors. Is there one person that would want to join St. Paul Family Ministries? Anybody at all? God bless you and God keep you. God make a space to shine upon you.
Yes.
Isn't God good?
Yeah.
Yes, he is. He's wonderful. He's a loving and kind God. So let's go to the Lord in prayer as we get ready to leave. Father in heaven, you're a mighty God.
Yes, you are.
You're a loving and kind God.
Yes, you are.
Lord, you're the God above all gods. And so, Lord, we thank you for taking us out of the darkness.
Yes, Father,
and giving us the light.
Yes.
We give you praise and we give you honor. We love you with all of our heart. Lord, we ask as we take our leave that you watch over us. That you keep us in your care.
Yes, Lord.
Not only keep us in your care, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
But encamp your angels around us.
Yes, Father.
Not
yes.
only your angels, Lord, but hold us in the palm of your hand.
Your hand, Lord.
Hold us close to your chest.
Yes, Father.
That we can hear your heartbeat.
Thank you.
Yes.
Lord, we love you. And we ask that you would watch over us in the name of the Father,
yes.
the Son,
yes.
and the Holy Spirit.
The Holy
we ask
Spirit.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Amen. Amen.